Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
I want to share a story with you. It's about a fisherman. One beautiful sunny day, a fisherman was lying on the beach with his fishing pole propped up in the sand and his solitary line cast out in the water. He was enjoying afternoon sun and the prospect of catching a fish. About noon, a businessman came walking down the beach, trying to relieve the stress of his workday. He decided to find out why the fisherman was relaxing instead of working harder to make money. He said to the fisherman, "You aren't going to catch many fish that way. You should be working rather than lying on the beach." The fisherman looked up at the businessman and said, "And what will my reward be?" The businessman answered, "Well, you get bigger. Bigger nets and catch more fish." And then the man looked at him again and said, "And what will my reward be?" The businessman replied, "You will make money. And you'll be able to buy a boat which gets you larger catches of fish." The man answered again, "And then, what will my reward be?" The businessman was angry. And he said, "Don't you get it? You can have people work for you." The man looked at him again and said, "What will my reward be?" The businessman was really angry. "The more money you make, the bigger the operation you can have. You can build up a fleet of boats, and all over the world you can catch fish, and let your employees do all the work for you." Once again, the fisherman asked, "And what will my reward be?" This businessman was red with rage at this time, and he shouted at the fisherman, "Don't you understand that you can become so rich that you'll not have a care in the world? You can spend all your days sitting on this beach looking at the sunset." The fisherman smiled and said, "So what you're saying is that I have to go through all that just to have what I have already." Our lives are consumed sometimes. A word that is very common in our desires is more. We set goals for ourselves. We reach them. And when we get there, we think we're going to be happy, but we're not satisfied. We convince ourselves that there is happiness, and we continue to pursue. And we think with just a little more, we'll get there. And that more becomes more and more and more. We never really find contentment. We never really find happiness. Because the happiness that we seek is not in the things that we own or the size of our bank account. It's nothing that we can acquire. It's something that has to be from deep inside of us. Today's gospel, Jesus is setting out on a journey. And a man comes running up to him and kneels down before him and asks him, "Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" The question is one that each and every one of us at some time in our lives have asked. I know that part of me is right there with that man, waiting for an answer. I can relate to his question. In Mark's gospel, the man is not identified as rich at the outset. But in Matthew and Luke, he's identified as a young rich man. Mark tells us that Jesus answers the man and tells him, "Keep the commandments." And the man answers very confidently, "I have kept the commandments all my life." Jesus looks back at the man with love because he knows what he's saying is true. But he also knows that he has one thing in his life that is keeping him from finding true happiness. One thing that is keeping him from God. And he tells him, "Then go, sell what you have, and give the money to the poor. And then you will have treasure in heaven. Then come and follow me." The man was distraught at Jesus' answer, and he went away, very sad because he had many possessions. That young man today came seeking. He could not give up the things of the world that he had accumulated. He had material wealth, but he did not have happiness. He owned a lot, but did not have peace. He came seeking, and Jesus looked deep into his heart and saw the problem and gave him a solution. But the man couldn't accept what Jesus was saying. He was owned by his possessions. He was materially rich, but spiritually poor. Sometimes in our lives, we can become like the man in this gospel. We get caught up in the world, a world that tells us that more is better. We live on the periphery of our faith, and we think it's enough, but we find out it's not. My brothers and sisters, that is our lesson today. A lesson that tells us that we cannot find happiness in more, but rather in faith. True faith. A faith that teaches us to live as Christ taught us. When Jesus tells the rich young man to sell all his possessions and give the money to the poor and follow him, he is calling him to discipleship. He calls each and every one of us the same way. He calls us to rid ourselves of the material things that own us and to live our lives in his service as his disciples. As disciples of Christ, we know that true happiness is not found in things, but rather in the love of God that surrounds us. Our desire for happiness can never be satisfied by possessions. Our dream for peace and contentment will never be satisfied by wealth, but rather true happiness comes from living our lives in Christ. Today, we are called to seek the richness of God in our lives, to live in his light, to grow and prosperous in his love. The essence of our lives as disciples of Christ is giving. Giving. We are called to live in the image and likeness of God who is giving. Consider this. These are the words from John 3:16. God so loved the world that he gave. He gave. Our riches are meant to be shared. We are called to remember the poor, the grieving, the sick, and the imprisoned. We are called to give ourselves for the good of others, in the image of Jesus who gave his life for you and for me. We are called to love as we are loved. St. Paul tells us that very thing in his first letter to Timothy in the 6th chapter. Here's what he says. Tell the rich in the present age not to be proud and not to rely on so uncertain a thing as wealth, but rather God, who richly provides us with all things for our enjoyment. Tell them to be good, to be rich in good works, to be generous, ready to share, thus accumulating as treasure a good foundation for the future, so as to win life, that is, true life. There's a lesson there for us. True life, true happiness comes from sharing the gifts that we've been given. The lesson for all of us is not that wealth is a bad thing, because everything that we have, everything that we will have, and everything that we are is a gift from God. The lesson is that if we have been blessed, we have an obligation well beyond ourselves. Scripture tells us, to those that have been given much, much is expected. Blessings are to be shared and not to be kept for ourselves. Like the rich young man, we cannot let the things of the world own us. We are called to give our hearts to God and God alone. Today, Jesus calls us to give up the things that keep us from Him and to seek more love, more faith, more trust in God, because that is where true happiness can be found. The fisherman that was confronted by the businessman on the beach was happy. He did not need to pursue the ever-elusive more of this world. He was living the life that God had blessed him with. And that brought him happiness. Happiness that the businessman did not understand. The fisherman had found what really mattered in life, and it wasn't material wealth. I want to share with you one more quote from Scripture. It's beautiful. It's from the Book of Wisdom. Here's what it says. Therefore I prayed, and understanding was given to me. I called on God, and the Spirit of Wisdom came to me. I preferred her to scepters and thrones, and I accounted wealth as nothing in comparison with her. Neither did I liken her to any priceless gem, because all gold is just a little bit of sand in her sight. And silver will be accounted for as clay before her. I loved her more than health and beauty, and I chose to have her rather than life, because her radiance never ceases. All good things come to me along with her, and it is her in her hands is unaccounted wealth. Wisdom is the wisdom of God. That's what we seek. Amos said, seek God and live. We need to do that. We need to seek God and live. It's not a wealth that we are looking for. It is the wisdom of God. It is striving to see things as God sees them, to understand as God understands, to use our talents, our time, our talents, and our treasures to work up for the foundation of God on this earth. Our very works make us closer to God, to lead our families in love. That, my brothers and sisters, is what really matters in life. You may be well off financially, or you may struggle, but what really matters is that your life involves and is centered around the love of God. That is wisdom. That is what really matters. So today, all of us pray. We pray for wisdom, to know what is important in our lives. We pray for the wisdom of God and the courage to follow where He leads us. Amen.
Amen.